based on the work of my colleague Andrew Kotla, which elaborated this work with the planning team, specifically for the city of Gori. But I will be generalizing this topic on the national level because there are many similarities and the reality is the same for every region. Universal access to education is a very important topic and very actual topic for Georgia because it's a very problematic, and I will be talking about the importance, and I will be talking the standards which are currently in Georgia, and I will be also presenting the elaborated recommendations. So we will be concentrating on primary and secondary educational facilities, which are the important part of the social infrastructure and which creates the quality of life. But we will not be talking about the high educational facilities at the universities because it requires some additional data as what are the popular professional directions or what is the link that your university just sets because it's it makes a difference for the accessibility. So educational as a social infrastructure means that it is financed by the government. It does not generate income. This is why that it is often reviewed as a secondary issue, because we do not know what is the income of the school, and they prefer to invest money in other directions. But when we look at the charge of the impact of education on the urban standard of living, we can see that it is in the chain reaction because it creates a quality working force, and therefore it raises the GDP per person, per citizen, and therefore it creates the urban quality, sets the urban quality of life. So investing in education means investing in the quality of life in the long run perspective. We can see it tomorrow, we can see maybe 5 years, but we will see that in 50, 10 years. The second, yes. As accessibility means many things, we will be talking about accessibility through the urban prism of special planning. It means that it can be divided into two concepts. The first is reachability, and the second is availability. I'll be describing what is reachability. Reachability is we are every school has a service radius, which is dependent on the walking radius, on the walking time and walking speed. It means that the service radius is dependable on how reachable is it for me, how soon can I get to school. But the service radius is also dependent on the urban built-up environment. It means that if we take, for example, Tbilisi, in Tbilisi the service radius is 750 meters, but for Gori it will be 1 kilometer because the build-up intensity is lower. It means that you have less obstacles and the walking speed is greater. The second part of the concept is availability. Availability means that we have to determine the capacity of the school. The school has the territory, and there are special standards to determine how many square meters per student do we have to not have the congestion that we have in school today. But we have to have standards to determine reachability and availability, and this is the part where it gets very tricky, because in Georgia we have a current standard that is the accreditation norm, which said that it's only 4 square meters per student. And when we compare that to other standards, to the construction codes and regulations, the Russian codes from the SSSR, that it is current and is realistic for our urban structure, because for many years the city was arranged by these codes. When we compare to this, it's from 40 to 17 square meters per pupil, which is dependent on the number of pupils in China. So if we have less than 500 pupils, then it should be 40 square meters. But if we have like a school that is 1,500 pupils, then we have 17 to 21. And if we compare that, we should say that the accreditation norm that we have now depicts the current situation. a very big problem of the land resource. And if the accreditation norm was bigger, it would be a problem because many schools will be closed or many people will be kicked out of the school without any alternative because we don't have any school infrastructure, we don't have any territories. The second is in the 40 square meters, we have not only the school building, but we have also the recreational space. We also have the school restaurant, which we don't have now in Georgia. There's very few schools that have this kind of infrastructure, which is very important. And the third is the Euro standard, which is our goal, our long-term goal, which is not realistic that we have this now. But for the long run, we should set this goal. It's like 46 to 60 square meters and plus. We have some recommendations to alleviate the situation now. There are four basic recommendations. The first one is optimization. Optimization means that we can create a homogeneous layer of the service radiuses of the schools, and the whole city should be covered by this layer. And the second one, we also have to determine what are the territorial requirements for the school and how many pupils can it serve and without creating any congestion. The problem is that sometimes we don't have that, not sometimes, but I don't know any school that's I think it's very, very unusual for this. The second one is the additional territorial resource provision. It means that if the school has some free space or free territory around it, it should be part of the school itself. Therefore, we have more territories, we can make this school accessible to more pupils. And it is also one recommendation. But there are some I forgot my word, it's okay. There are sometimes we don't have the free space near the school, but in the SNPs, the constructional codes and regulations, we have that if in the service radius there are some recreational spaces like sports infrastructure or maybe gardens, squares, parks, it also should be directed towards the school because it also serves the children, which doesn't have any recreational opportunities in the school, but have the service in the radius. And the fourth recommendation, which is the most invasive one and the most problematic one, because there are some critical situations when we don't have free space, we can't optimize the school, and we don't have to cost the school. But we can convert them into preschools because preschools have less territorial demand than schools, and we can just convert them into preschools. So, for conclusion, we have to say that it's very important ensuring the territorial resource today for schools will ensure our quality of life tomorrow. Maybe not tomorrow, literally, but for the long run, it is a very important subject. And as land resource is an exhaustible resource, it means that if we want to make the transition period less painful and less difficult, we have to form knowledge, our demand, and plan accordingly. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.